First officer's log, stardate 2933-14.15. The Ricardo was ordered to the Terran star system by Admiral Nandium, and over there on the third planet, we found a civilization that we started calling the Batu civilization. We found that the Batu civilization was able to colonize the entire planet, despite having primitive technology. However, we also found a lot of fallout by the sediments. Basically, all of them were completely annihilated. So this indicates that there was some kind of nuclear warfare that destroyed them. However, what caused it remains unknown. We did find one settlement that was relatively untouched. We called the settlement Kibat. And over there, we also found a body that was pretty well preserved. And they called this spot, they called this organism Hikalibre Omnium Draconius Yoshiaki, or Ericodi. So they used a positronic dilithium-based tetracarbonate reader to reconstruct its brain. And once that was done, the archaeology team used an atmospheric trimedium heptaneide recorder to read the brain activity and piece together what happened and just its memory in general. So they found that Cody was about, when the first recording was when Cody was approximately 15 orbits old, and he was starting, and it was starting this school, and the system was known as MPX, and it was kind of like our schools back on Patrisu 7, where it's a lot more project based and applying it to real world. So there, Cody needed to learn a lot of problem solving skills, aside from just duct tape and zip ties. And unlike the standard route, kind of like the Mordolian education system, where they're all about memorizing things and for tests. And however, Cody was not very efficient. So Dr. Nexium, our head of the archaeology team, said, quote, "He was horrible at managing his time, put off homework to last minute, and stopped in the middle of working to play games." So we came up with this hypothesis that basically this species was lazy, and once they acquired nuclear weapons, they destroyed themselves. Kind of like the Oketsu theory of civilization annihilation. However, we did find that Cody was kind of had trouble communicating and socially awkward. So we kind of think this could drop the last theory because he wouldn't represent the entire Batu civilization. However, the weird thing was that when we took our final, our second reading was of the latest time we could reconstruct, which was about half an orbit later, and there we could find that that the Cody had improved communication skills, the work ethic kind of similar to the Shoinian, and the planning skills that rival that of the Nambians. And so, in other words, the old hypothesis of them destroying themselves because they're incompetent was out the window. So, in other words, the entire archaeology team and the ship itself was baffled by this discovery. So they took more readings, and they found out that MPX had a major impact in causing what happened. And so it basically lasted for 0.75 orbits, where Cody was assigned to a group, or as some people started calling it, a year-long project. And however, despite well-preserved it was, we couldn't recover the nectohydride stannium, which was gone, so we couldn't figure out that much information about the other people. However, we were able to figure out the first project, which was an infographic with the year-long project, and it was about climate change. Basic idea behind climate change was that the Batian civilization used this kind of bad version of dilithium to get their energy, and that caused a lot of carbon emissions that threw off the entire climate of place. And so because of that, Cody was forced to do a lot of research on his own time on the internet, or kind of like a primitive version of our Universal Library database. And that So it started to show that MPX was focused on more improving the skills that you lack. You were forced to make up for the lack of work ethic by just giving a lot more work. But not only that, we also figured out that Cody was kind of advanced in math. He was learning pre-calc at the time, and while pre-calculus is normally taught to 7-year-olds, in this civilization it tends to be more adolescents, almost people who were almost at the maturity of adults start to learn pre-calculus. So he was definitely ahead of the curve, and definitely ahead of the rest of MPX. However, Cody was kind of, instead of just using the MPX thing, math, as a review, started applying the pre-calculus to the engineering work that they're doing in pre-calculus, using radians for calculating the calculating momentum and spinning wheel. And in general, that kind of also helped the work, his work ethic. Another thing that they did was the social movement theory. There, they didn't have our kind of atmospheric tritium heptaneid recorders or positronic dilithium based titanium carbonate readers, so they couldn't kind of reconstruct the person's brain and figure out what they're thinking on their own. So they had to form theories about it. Their theory was that whenever something is censored, it the Batians were kind of curious, so they wanted to figure it out. So not really that far off from what we've recorded about Cody's data. However, we're not sure about the rest of the Batian civilization. But he was doing a lot of artwork, and this also made forced Cody to do a lot of work on his own time, kind of raising the work ethic and the quality of work that he was forced to do. And this basically completely destroyed our old hypothesis of them destroying themselves because they were competent. So instead, we formed a new hypothesis about the education system, where it's supposed to prepare them for the real world. And MPX did it in a very different way by giving them obstacles and having them overcome it, rather than in the standard way where it seems to indicate more just people trying to avoid failure. And we were also able to determine that the Batian adolescents' survival after they reach adulthood is based off their ability to adapt. So because of that, we're able to figure out that MPX is actually kind of better for the Batian civilization. However, we also found pretty good records in this one location about the Batian civilization. So Orbit 001 is what we refer to as when they started burning fuel. And around Orbit 53, we found that there are evidence of a giant war going on with primitive forms of spacecraft and vehicles. However, after the end of that war, which took many lives, at Orbit 60.91, the Batus Union was formed from representatives from different regions. However, around Orbit 72 is when they realized the dangers of climate change and the fuels that they're using. At Orbit 114.44, that was when Cody was born. And in Orbit 142.21, there's disputes start to break out among the Batus Union, ended with them being dissolved over who's to blame about the climate change. At Orbit 142.56, the former MPX students, like Cody and a few others, formed Honitai, a new form of government for Kibat. And in Orbit 142.73, they completely isolated themselves. In Orbit 143.49, Opia, when the cities was destroyed by a nuclear missile launch from Ironton, and by Orbit 145.13, all of the settlements were basically destroyed except for Kibat. So basically, Cody and MPX were able to save Kibat from nuclear annihilation, mainly because of the MPX and how it taught them how to go over obstacles rather than just avoid them altogether. And at Orbit 129.95, we had our final reading from the atmospheric tritium heptaneid recorder. In that, Cody was about to give a speech about how MPX helped him. And he was kind of, we could tell that he was nervous before it, and we assumed that he was probably nervous during it. However, we're unsure about what happened. We're unsure about what exactly happened since the recorder cut off right before the speech started. And we can assume that he either learned from the experience or adapted to the challenge and was successful altogether. Because we found out that he wasn't allowed to use his skill, his use of technology, and forcing him to adapt. And we can assume this because of all the things that he went on to accomplish later. However, at orbit 149.73, he died of tuberculosis, and orbit 210.39, the kibat food supply was damaged, and by orbit 211.92, the entire Batu's civilization went extinct. So because of that, we can draw quite a few conclusions about the Batu civilization. One of them being that MKX was one of the most influential things in what made it what it is. However, more towards the later end, we can assume that had it grasped the rest of the world, then they could have saved the entire world from